The heart is like an amazing, amazing organ. It beats 100,000 times a day. It pumps with every beat about 5 liters of blood. It pipes that blood through 60,000 miles of blood vessels. So it never goes to sleep. It beats every single day, every minute, every second. And we're expecting a lot out of this pump. And with eating and not exercising, our arteries become gummed up. It becomes blocked with cholesterol plaques. And with things like blood pressure, high blood pressure, cholesterols that are out of control, diabetes, which makes your cholesterol more sticky, so they're more likely to stick in your arteries. In terms of cholesterol, there's very good data that when you stop eating foods that are high in trans fat, that you increase your good cholesterol and you can lower your bad cholesterol. And of course, you know, when you're eating diets that are good for you, that are filling you up, that are not so calorie rich, for example, lots of vegetables, we know that some people can actually lose weight. Losing weight alone can lower your blood pressure, lower your cholesterol, and decrease your risk of getting diabetes. So it really has a very dramatic effect.
Of course, my first step is I take a nutrition assessment, what they're typically eating. I take a look at alcohol intake, supplements, exercise activity, and that gives me a full picture. And then I work on incorporating more of the Mediterranean style diet. Inflammation affects your whole system. So we can be over hyper focused on the heart, which we know is extremely important, but all the body works together. So we're reducing inflammation everywhere, which is only going to help the heart work better. Change takes time. So it's a matter, like I said, of starting to work on really incorporating the healthy foods first. So as we know, the Mediterranean diet is high in omega-3 fatty acids from fish. So trying to get more fish in the diet, tons of extra virgin olive oil. We know there's phenomenal benefits in extra virgin olive oil. There's a lot of benefits to soluble fiber. So that's another foundation of the Mediterranean diet. So a lot of fruits and vegetables, grains and beans, nuts and seeds. We don't want to necessarily look at foods that are good or bad for the heart. I mean, we know there are certain foods that are bad, but just looking at a holistic approach and looking at how you can improve your overall health with the food choices you make and make those foods that are less healthy few and far between. So just focus on adding more, and I think you'll naturally decrease the foods that aren't necessarily as good for us.
There's so much information out there, and oftentimes I think our patients find it very overwhelming. And it's a good idea to go see a nutritionist if you can, and ask your doctor for help, you know, when you go to your annual exam. You know, we often think it's a moral failing. It's not a moral failing. And it's okay to ask for help, to get back on good dietary plan. And also, this is a complementary thing. You do it in conjunction with medications for our patients with heart disease, and that's okay.